Very good evening to CE and CSS, committee members, partners from SMU, NUSISS, Ngee Ann Polytechnic, and Lytton Academy, colleagues from the public service, and friends from the social service sector. I am Alexa from the National Council of Social Service, and we are very happy to have you with us today to celebrate a milestone in our sector's Digitalisation Action Roadmap. Together with our partners from the various institutes of higher learning and training organizations, we will be launching a series of programs for nonprofits, bringing us one step closer to a digitally ready and able sector. As we begin the program proper, we seek everyone's understanding to ensure that your cameras and mics are turned off throughout the session. Without further ado, may we now invite Ms. Tan Lee Sun, CEO of NCSS, to give her opening remarks, please. CE, please.
Thank you very much. Very good afternoon to everybody. I want to acknowledge our training partners from SMU, NUSISS, Ngee Ann Polytechnic, and Lytton Academy, colleagues from the Public Service, MSF, MCCY, SSG, AIC, and Tote Board, and friends and colleagues. Really happy to be here today. At the launch of the Invictus Fund second tranche on 28 September, Minister for Social and Family Development, Mr. Masagos, challenged SSAs to transform from SSA 1.0 to SSA 3.0. That is to say, you know, SSAs that are driven by committed social service professionals, augmented by volunteers and enabled by technology to serve the needs of end users and Singaporeans. So for SSAs to transform digitally, it is critical for agencies to invest in developing their human capital by upskilling and reskilling their workforce. And in the social service sector, you know, where corporate functions are thin and lean, such capabilities are usually not found in-house. And also we know that in this sector, hiring and retaining IT talent is sometimes difficult due to the salary and career pathways compared to the other options that IT talents have. So with the Tech and Go funding that NCSS launched 2 months ago, SSAs now can obtain funding to adopt technology, whether it's pre-scoped IT solutions or more bespoke solutions customized to their needs. But the benefits of technology, whether it's productivity gains or, you know, more user satisfaction, can only be reaped if the organizations have the right capabilities to go along with the technology. So, you know, the most intelligent technology is irrelevant if we don't have the skills to use it. Conversely, the most skilled professionals will become obsolete if they don't capitalize on technology. So we believe that technology adoption and digital capability building go hand in hand. And upskilling, reskilling must happen at the pace of technology changes. And in many sectors, right, these digital skills have become so much a core part of their everybody's role. They're no longer, you know, just the purview of the IT department. In fact, many of these are skills that need to be embedded across the organization, across different functions, across different business units, across different levels of the organization. So in our sector, likewise, right, we feel that SSA leaders need to build a case for digital transformation, come up with a transformation agenda for the organization. Managers who work with vendors need to know enough about technology to articulate their needs, to specify requirements, to assess the suitability of vendors, and also to integrate technology within their own processes. So we have heard SSA say, you know, some vendors bully us because we don't understand the technology or know the terms. So we really hope that, you know, to build this capability within SSAs. At the broader level, of course, SSA staff, you know, need to equip themselves with the skills so that they can be more confident in using technology in order to work more productively, in order to serve their users better. So for this reason, we are really very happy in NCSS to be partnering with all our institutes of higher learning here today, and of course our continuous education and training centers to offer training programs to really meet the needs of SSAs. So for a start, and I'll just read these out, the programs include Managing Change in Digital Age by SMU, a Professional Diploma in Digitalisation for Nonprofits with NUS ISS, Skills Future for Digital Workplace with Ngee Ann Polytechnic and Lytton Academy. So I believe our partners will be sharing more about these programs later on. So I should just add that NCSS has been working with each of them to contextualize and optimize the courses to suit the nonprofit sector. So some of these courses are designed for SSAs to attend as intact teams. I think it's not enough for one to two persons to just attend, they go back and then nobody knows the language in the organization. So we believe that, you know, when we send a team, we are more likely to be able to deliver the digital transformation outcomes and to sustain change in the long term. Many of these programs are also heavily subsidized, as much as 90% by Skills Future Singapore. Over the years, NCSS Social Service Institute has partnered with both local and overseas educational institutions to offer programs to uplift the capabilities of our social service sector. So, you know, for SSA leaders, for example, we have been collaborating with partners like INSEAD to offer capstone leadership programs. We have a Singapore Berkeley lecture series that's a collaboration with the University of California, Berkeley, where SSAs learn from leading experts on social work best practices. So we really are looking forward to this continued partnership, to these new partnerships with our IHLs and with our CET centers, really to uplift the capabilities of our sector. Maybe let me end by quoting a note that we received from Ms. Pauline Ruth Chin. She is the Executive Director of Calvary Community Care. She said that her SSA's interest in digital training stems from the desire to improve client and staff experience by using modern technology tools and by simplifying business processes. And she felt that there was no better way to be part of this process in empowering staff and clients than to be at the forefront of learning herself. So I really hope we can all embrace this spirit of continuous learning. So once again, truly appreciate this partnership that we're building with SMU, NUS ISS, Ngee Ann Polytechnic, Lytton Academy, and Skills Future Singapore, of course, as we work collectively to strengthen the capabilities of our sector. Thank you very much.
Thank you, CE.